and welcome to Somerset News Network. John Bercow, the Speaker of the House of Commons, has said that he will stop a no-deal Brexit going through. I thought the Speaker was supposed to be independent. I thought that he was the Speaker of the House of Commons, not a political activist. This is absolutely crazy. How can he basically overrule his own position? Now, people, I've said this morning on a blog on Facebook, I made the comment that the Speaker should have no eyes to see or tongue to speak. And I was lambasted by trolls. What are you talking about? That doesn't make sense. Now, history lesson. Let's get things straight. The Speaker is the chairman of the House of Commons. He is not a political party. Although he was a member of the Conservative Party and a Conservative MP, he does not take part in debates. He manages debates. He's the chairman. He has to be independent. He has to be impartial. For that impartiality, he should not make a comment or have a view. Hence my saying, no eyes to see or tongue to speak. And they lambast me? Haven't they been to school? Don't they learn politics anymore? I'll take you back. 1642, in the time of Cromwell, Charles I is still on the throne. Charles I goes to Parliament, takes the Speaker's chair, and demands that they hand over 5 members of Parliament for treason. He asks the he says to the Speaker, "I've seen the birds have flown." And then he says, "Where are they?" The Speaker, William Lenthall, turns to the King and says, "Your Majesty, I have no eyes to see or tongue to speak." It was done in the film Cromwell in 1970. You know, it was one of my favourite films, a bloody great film. Everybody should watch that film to understand about the English Civil War. How it happened, why it happened, how the king decided that he had the sole power and the divine right of kings. Parliament is sovereign. The king has not got the power. We've got the same problem today. We've got the Prime Minister. It was Tony Blair, then Cameron. All said they had the divine right of the crown. They used what they call the crown prerogative. They have not. They are not above the law. They have to do the will of the commons as well. But the commons is not sovereign. The people are sovereign because we vote for our MPs. The people have the power. The people are sovereign. The commons works for the people. The commons gave us the vote to leave or remain in the EU. We voted to leave. The commons should uphold that democratic vote. Full stop. Now, for the Speaker to come out and say that he's going to stop a no Brexit deal is well beyond his pay grade. Now, I'm going to play a little clip here for you, and this shows you. Charles II asked the Speaker, Where have they gone? This is a little clip from the film.
Mr. Speaker, gentlemen, you must pardon this infringement of your privilege, but I will not detain you long. Mr. Speaker, I must make bold with your chair. I have here a warrant for the arrest of 5 members of this House. John Pym, Henry Ireton, John Hampden, Oliver Cromwell, and Sir Arthur Haselrig, upon a charge of treason. I see that the birds have flown. Mr. Speaker, where are these gentlemen?
May it please your majesty, I have neither eyes to see nor tongue to speak, except as this house gives me leave.
Well, sir, I have eyes. I see that one of them is here. Captain?
Take him!
Stand aside!
Any action against any member of this house is a breach of privilege. And I move this house declares us public enemies, any who lay hands upon its members. I further move that any such action against this house be considered a crime against the people and treason against this nation.
Yes!
So be it. Mr. Speaker, you will inform the members of this House that their presence is no longer required by the nation. This Parliament is, by my authority, terminated, dissolved.
Your Majesty! Are you aware that by your action in this House today, you may have pushed this nation to the brink of civil war?
So you see, Cromwell sat in his seat and stood his ground, and Parliament had their say. Are we now in the same position we were then? Are external forces trying to control the Parliament? It's an odd one. Parliament is not doing the will of the people. The people voted to leave the EU. There are so many MPs who are pro-European and want to stop Brexit and want us to remain in, it's quite frightening. Over the years, has it been that the political parties have been infiltrated by people working for foreign powers? Are our MPs controlled by secret organisations that are pro-European Union? I ask the question because I don't know the answer. Hammond came out today and said that he would stop a no-deal Brexit and that Boris had no chance of getting another deal with the EU. The EU deal was done by the EU. May and her cohorts agreed to it. It was the mother of all bad deals. We should never have had it. So, Speaker comes out. MPs are now fighting. There's a civil war between MPs, basically. Those that want to leave the EU and those that want to remain. Doesn't matter what party they're in. So, anyway, just remember, this is what Bercow should remember. He should have no eyes to see or tongue to speak.
please, Your Majesty, I have neither eyes to see nor tongue to speak, except as this house gives me leave.